within the faraway land of Germany, about 4,732 miles, they got different etiquette. German culture be more refined, kinder, like we be looking like animals compared to them. Everyday lingo and language are usually more formal in Germany. Many items like that we just like don't consider like, you know, major, like whatever, we just consider it kind of minor. There they consider it like major disrespect, and like they'll get real pissed at you. And like enhancing this idea of like differing etiquette can be done simply through like examples of like everyday life and media, you know?
Example number one, what the dog doing?
Hey, let me get him in. Hey, let me get one too.
Let me hold him.
Yeah, you get that right there. What the dog doing?
You've seen how this well-liked media played out in its American form. Now let's examine its course with German values. Additionally, for extra realism, within this example, I've translated the video to German. Guten Tag, darf ich bitte habe eine Minze haben? Darf ich auch eine Minze haben bitte? Ich auch? Ja, Sie sind meine Freunde. In Germany, it is expected that when greeting people in a friendly manner, you'll shake their hands and say some form of a hello. Guten Tag could be used most of the time if it is not a night or morning. However, a more informal, common way of saying hello can be hallo. But it is recommended you do not use this greeting with someone you're not familiar with. One should use the formal Z, as in Wie geht es Ihnen, in this clip. It is safe to use the greeting, hallo, as we can infer they probably know this person if they're asking them for such a commodity as mint. Additionally, the clothing in the footage should be different. Germans typically prefer business casual clothing, unlike Americans with their white sneakers and white socks. Roll footage.
It was not just gravity, it was gravity and magnetism.
Danke für die Minze. Ich schätze es. Vielen Dank, Freunde. Bitte sehr. Was macht der Hund? In conclusion of that segment, we can observe a lack of thanks and sincerity from the Americans. Very informally, they pressure this man, who they may not even know, into giving them mints. Meanwhile, the Germans ask nicely and convince this man into giving them mints. They present themselves as sincere people who mean well to him by shaking his hand and giving thanks. Next, as another media example of differences in German and American etiquette, we examine a video posted on the popular American phone application TikTok, appearing to make fun of German culture. Additionally, we find another social media post appearing to have the same hostile intentions. Weirdly, it may seem that Americans tend to think of themselves as superior to other cultures, while Germans tend to encourage other cultures. Shocking this may seem, but this is a significant difference between the etiquette of German and American culture. Americans commonly show hostility to those who think differently of them. It can certainly be seen in their political system. However, different cultures are looked down on far less by Germans. They don't expect you to try and assimilate like an American would, but they'll applaud you for it. However, even if you're not the best German speaker or follower of German culture, they won't see you as some foreign outcast who needs to go back where they came from. Moreover, another difference between the etiquette of Germans and Americans is vulgarness. Germans' approach to speech is much more lighthearted and professional. For example, if you were to research German insults, you may find phrases like Teletubby Zurich Winke, meaning someone who waves back at Teletubbies, fictional cartoon characters. It's supposed to be an insult to a person's intelligence, but to the average American, this makes no sense and doesn't make anyone laugh. Meanwhile, Americans hold back way less and incorporate vulgarness into their lives a lot. For most American teenagers, expletives are a common ingredient in their speech. We can observe a vast difference in how American and German youth act. Just think about it. Americans are seen as loud, rambunctious, and arrogant. Meanwhile, Germans pride themselves on discipline. That's why they call Germany the fatherland. As an example, here are just a handful of the many examples of how American etiquette, the American way, displays itself in our classrooms.
Get the hell out of here.
As you can see, the American lives up to its reputation and owns it. They do not see it as something to be wary of, but something to pride themselves on, and gives them confidence about being rough around the edges. Meanwhile, the etiquette of the German classroom is more refined. Being late in Germany is about as worse as being dead. Nobody operates around a time, but instead at that time. So being late is a major sign of disrespect. It shows you don't care. Next, it is also expected you make use of materials given to you during the course. If you receive something, you're expected to read it. Unlike America, the German classroom isn't a place where you blindly accept what's told to you. Students are welcome to challenge your teacher's ideas, but you must be respectful about it. They encourage discussion in the classroom and would rather hear differing opinions than the same agreeing ideas from everyone. The etiquette of the German classroom is respectful. It is ground for developing ideas, developing minds. Within the next segment, we can verify this notion. In conclusion, the everyday etiquette of Americans and Germans are different. The actions of Americans can be seen as rude and annoying by many. Meanwhile, the German tries their best to respect everyone. They don't push anyone aside or try to intimidate anyone. They welcome you. Their friendliness is unmatched. They'll greet you with a handshake. They'll always say please and thank you. And they'll never take anything they're given for granted. The end.
Aww, that's so nice.
Shut up!